Hi, welcome to Savvy's Fashion Studio. I'm Savita. For more full-fledged online classes and for quality sewing tools, please visit our website savvysfashionstudio.com. In the first part of this video, we had shown how to install this rough flow presser foot for your commercial or industrial sewing machine. As the video was longer, in the second part, I'm showing how to sew on fabric, that is make ruffles on fabric, and also how to chain the dye in the rough flow foot. Now let's start sewing and try on different fabrics and see how it pleats. Now I'm threading to the needle eye. Because of this attachment, your finger does not go there. So use a tweezer like this to pull the thread. Now I'm trying to make the pleats with different fabrics. Now with this ruffler, you can do pleats on a single layer of fabric, or you can also do the pleats and simultaneously attach it to another fabric. So first we'll see how to make the pleats in single layer of fabric. I'm trying with this ready ribbon. If you want to pleat a single layer, this is how you insert. There's a guide here. Put it in this way, and then take it under this blade and position. Let there be some extra here. Now see the needle position. That is where you will get the stitch. If you want the stitch to be to the edge, then you will have to move the ribbon to this side. For now, I'll keep it in the center. Now put the presser foot down. So let's see how this pleats. Now don't hold this fabric tight because it needs to move freely to pleat. Just hold it to guide where the stitch has to be. Now if you see, after every 4 stitches, there is a pleat. That is because of this die. I had shown you another die which has 8 grooves. That means after every 8 stitch, there will be a pleat, which we'll see later. When you do this, try to maintain a uniform speed. If you keep changing the speed, like if you go high speed, there are chances of the stitches skipping. So maintain a uniform speed when you do this. Now slowly remove it. So this is how beautifully it pleats. We saw pleating on a single layer of fabric. Now let's see how to pleat and simultaneously attach it to another fabric. This is a skirt at the hem of which I want to attach the ruffles. So place this under, lift the presser foot, raise your needle and place this under. So if you have kept a half inch seam, position the needle half inch in from the edge. Now take the fabric that you want to ruffle. I'm using this ready ribbon. Now I'm placing this right side facing down, that is right on right, because after pleating I'll be turning it this way. If you're just attaching the ruffle and you're not turning it later, you can keep the right side facing up. So the fabric to be ruffled is to be under the blade. Again, position it in such a way that the needle is in the seam line. You only have to make sure fabric edges are aligned. Place where you join, just cross it over the other and continue. For that, I'll just trim this off. Carefully remove because you don't want to damage the blade. Once that is damaged, it may not pleat well. Now I'll overlock the seam and turn it to the wrong side and do a top stitch. So you can see how beautifully it has pleated. It's so even, which is a little difficult when you're doing manually. I've used this ready bias tape, which is 1 inch wide. So the skirt is ready. The ruffler made this part very easy. And on top, I've just put a exposed elastic. In one of our previous videos, I've shown how to sew an exposed elastic to the skirt waist. To reduce the depth of the pleat, this is the screw you need to adjust just under this. Loosen the screw. Once you loosen, you can move this. You can move this lever. So I had kept to the max, that is on top, for the maximum depth. Bring it wherever you want and tighten the screw completely. Once you get this foot, you will have to try with different positions to see how the pleat depth is. So try it on a scrap fabric before doing it on an actual garment. So let's try this. Now I have kept it in the center. You can also take it to the lowest where the pleat depth is the least. So if you see, the pleat depth is less now compared to the previous ruffle that we did. Now let's see how to remove the presser foot. First of all, switch off the machine. Remove the thread. Remove the needle. To remove the needle, by turning the hand wheel, raise the needle bar up to the highest position. And from this side, you can see the screw. Slightly loosen the screw to remove the needle. Raise the presser foot. Now loosen this presser feed screw. Remove the screw completely. Now slowly slide it from the presser feed bar by tilting it this way. Now this has come out and slowly remove. Now let's change to the other die. Before changing the die, just see all the parts how it should be, because we have to put it back the same way. Loosen the screw. Remove the complete set in this way and then only change the die. So this part sits in here and this will go to the foot here. Now first insert the screw so it's easier to hold. So now when you try to put, it's difficult because this lock is coming in the way. Now push the lock down and insert. Then tighten the screw by turning towards you. Tighten it completely. After tightening the screw, see that this moves freely. If it's not moving, then it would not pleat. So do all the adjustments here and then install it in your machine. Again, when holding, be careful. The blade can hurt you, so keep your fingers away. This ruffler attachment comes with an installation manual. There is a sheet of paper which explains how you install it. But then it does not explain the challenges you may face, which I realized when I was trying this presser foot. So I decided to make this video, what challenges you may face and how to rectify. Thanks for watching this video. See you soon in the next class. Until then, happy sewing. Join our online sari blouse foundation course on our website www.savisfashionstudio.com and learn to make well-fitting sari blouses for any size. Easily learn to make different kinds like choli, princess, padded, katori, high neck and many more. You will learn from taking body measurements, drafting your own pattern and sewing the blouse. Our sewing tips will help you stitch the blouse with professional finish. So join now and happy sewing!